The COVID vaccine fertility and miscarriage study is an ongoing data collection effort being conducted here at IVF1. This study compares the fertility and miscarriage outcomes of women who have received vaccination against COVID-19, women who have been infected with COVID-19, those who had both, and those who had neither. Part one of the study has now been published in a peer-reviewed medical journal. It is available to view here. If you prefer to read the medical journal, the link is in the description below. Since we released that episode, it has been viewed over 140,000 times. I have received a number of questions and comments about the study and about COVID vaccines and fertility in general. Today, I am going to reveal more data from the study and answer some viewer questions, some serious and some humorous. Some people have commented that since the study did not show any adverse impact on fertility or miscarriage, that I must be on the payroll of a pharmaceutical company. I am not. I am a board-certified fertility expert at IVF1 in the Naperville Fertility Center in the United States. I do not work for any pharmaceutical companies, nor have I in the past. The study did not receive any funding from any pharmaceutical companies or from any governmental agency. I did all of the patient care and data collection myself. Some have questioned how it is possible to have results about fertility since it hasn't yet been 9 months since the study began. Let's go over some basics. Fertility is about the ability to become pregnant. In 2021, there are many ways in which we can determine whether a woman has become pregnant. There are blood tests and urine tests which measure the pregnancy hormone HCG, and there are ultrasounds which can show a pregnancy inside the body. It is not necessary to wait 9 months to determine if a woman has become pregnant. Our study looked at women who were attempting to become pregnant using IVF. During this process, an embryo is placed into the uterus. If the embryo implants, she is pregnant. If it does not implant, she is not pregnant. We could accurately determine whether a pregnancy was established by a blood test done 8 days after placing the embryo into the uterus. The study began in early January. Since then, we have performed 200 embryo transfers and subsequently obtained a blood pregnancy test. 44% of the transfers were in women who had COVID antibodies in their blood. A little less than two-thirds of those were from vaccination, about one-third from previous infection, and just a few women who had infection and then were vaccinated later. We performed statistical analysis of the results to determine whether one group was any better or worse than the other. 77% of the embryo transfers in women without COVID antibodies resulted in a pregnancy. 76% of the transfers in previously vaccinated women resulted in a pregnancy, and 71% of the women with previous infection became pregnant. Although it may seem like women with previous infection had a lower pregnancy rate, statistical analysis showed that this group was no different than the others. The fertility of the vaccinated women was no different than the non-vaccinated group. Let's talk about miscarriage next. A miscarriage is defined as the loss of a pregnancy that was implanted in the uterus during the first 20 weeks of pregnancy. However, the vast majority of miscarriages occur in the first several weeks of pregnancy. We followed these pregnancies until we were able to see fetal heart motion at least twice a week apart. Only a tiny percentage of miscarriages occur after a fetus with heart motion has been seen on ultrasound. This is why fertility doctors will send their patients back to their obstetricians after seeing heart motion. It's because the likelihood of miscarriage happening after that is so small. The miscarriage rate in our study was 30.7% in the women who did not receive the vaccine, 30.6% in those who did receive the vaccine, and 28.9% in those with previous infection. Statistical analysis, no different between these three groups. In humans, many miscarriages are due to chromosome abnormalities in the embryo. As a result, many of our IVF patients choose to test their embryos for chromosome abnormalities. This is known as PGT. This is an excellent group to study miscarriages since we don't have to worry about abnormal embryos skewing the data. We looked at the miscarriage rate in each group for those couples that tested their embryos. Women who were vaccinated miscarried 26.3% of the time. Women who were not vaccinated miscarried 29.4% of the time. And women with previous infection miscarried 27% of the time. Statistical analysis, no difference between the three groups. COVID vaccination was not associated with a higher rate of miscarriage. This matches the results found in the COVID vaccine trials conducted by Pfizer, Moderna, and Johnson & Johnson. Remember, in those studies, women were told not to get pregnant, but some did anyway by accident. Half of the women in the trials got the actual vaccine, but the other half did not. If we compare the miscarriage rates between those that got the vaccine and those that didn't, we find that the vaccine group had half as many miscarriages as the non-vaccine group. Many countries, including the U.S., have been closely monitoring for vaccine problems or side effects. The U.S. developed the V-Safe program, which sends text messages to participants with web links to a survey that asks about adverse reactions and health status. This study reported on pregnancy outcomes reported through the V-Safe program. Roughly 35,000 women of reproductive age were identified. 13.5% of them reported a positive pregnancy test after receiving one of the COVID vaccines. 12.6% of them reported a miscarriage. This is well within the range expected for a population study like this. For those of you keeping track, first, they said that every woman who received the vaccine would become sterile and never be able to become pregnant again because the vaccine was part of a secret plot to depopulate the planet. Then, our study and others showed that women were getting pregnant after vaccination. Then they said, well, those women will have infertility, which we showed is not the case. Next, they said that the vaccine will cause more miscarriages, which multiple studies have now shown is also not true. This is a surefire indicator of a conspiracy theory. Once you provide evidence that it is untrue, they move the goalposts. One viewer commented, if you had done any research, you would know that the nanobots activate 2 to 3 years after taking vaccines. You seem very dumb to think it activates right away. Another states that studies prove that the effects won't show up for 4 to 8 generations. Given that there are about 4 generations per century, that means that we can't declare anything safe for 200 years. That leaves us with no proven safe vaccines, but also no proven safe medications. And for that matter, no flying in airplanes, driving in cars, listening to the radio, watching television, or typing ridiculous comments on YouTube video. Look, folks, we live in a society together. If we were at war, we would all need to pull together to fight our enemy for the common good. Well, guess what? We are at war. Our enemy is small, deadly, and relentless. The more we let this enemy spread from person to person, the more it changes and the harder it becomes to stop. Vaccination is a potent weapon against this enemy. Getting a vaccine not only protects you, it protects those around you, especially the most vulnerable members of our society. Together, and only together, we can win this war. Infertility TV is your most trusted source for accurate information on infertility and miscarriage. If you are not a subscriber yet, hit the subscribe button right now. A new episode is released every week. You can also check us out on our website, ivf1.com, where you can become a patient.